Good morning. This is Mary Ellen McGonigal, and you're watching the MEM Edge show. This is the show where we put you in front of where the action is. And we are seeing a little bit of a bounce today. But before we get into that, let's go ahead and take a look at what we are going to be covering today. And that first item is going to be a review of the current markets. We want to get a good standing of where the broader markets lay, what their outlook is. Before you put any real money to work, it's important for you to have a game plan and, again, a real strong sense of just where the markets are positioned going into this week. From there, I'm going to review and share with you 15 liquid top performing yield stocks, and they were very easily attained using StockCharts.com alert and scanning system. So I'll share that with you and we'll review some of those stocks. And also, we're going to do today what's called a sector focus. I'm going to share with you some consumer related stocks that are really bucking the current chaos in the markets, as well as outperforming the broader markets going back at least over the last 6 months. And each of these stocks, there are very sound reasons for that. So I'm going to share that with you with an eye toward pointing you toward very technically sound stocks currently, but also to share with you those components that make these stocks outperformers so that you can use those same components within other sectors to uncover these very same types of stocks. And then also, hopefully we'll get time. We are still at the very tail end here of earnings season. And it's during this tail end period that it is consumer related stocks, primarily retailers that report. So we're going to be reviewing some of these higher profile retailers that are due to report last week. It was a rather robust week net for these consumer related stocks last week. And that is our agenda today. Before we go any further, I did want to share with you that the MEM Edge show that is normally recorded and shared live with you on Mondays at 10:30 a.m. Eastern time, we are moving to Fridays. I apologize. We are moving to Fridays at 3 p.m. Eastern time, not Monday. So it will be on Fridays at 3 p.m. And with that, we're going to be using Friday's close, the information. So in essence, you can review a rerun of this show at the same time it was normally shown live, 10:30 a.m. Eastern. But for those of you interested, you can see it live on Fridays at 3 p.m. You will get a jump start on that show that is normally aired on Mondays. So I did want to go ahead and share that with you. Let's go ahead and dig right into the broader markets where we are. As usual, I am sharing with you a daily chart of the S&P 500 index. So each bar, of course, is one day of trading activity. I've overlaid these simple moving averages for today. This green line is your 10-day simple moving average. The red is your 50-day. And then I also have the RSI, that's a relative strength indicator, on top. And then the stochastics, this is another momentum indicator that's being displayed here in the lower quartile of the screen. So let's jump right in here, take a look at where we are. Certainly it has been a very volatile, rather tough month here. This is August, pretty much this back and fill period here. What I've identified is what is called near-term support. And in essence, we're pointing you toward the lows that occurred in the beginning of August. If we break below the lows that were hit in that August 5th period, we can certainly look for potential further downside. And from there, the next possible area of support is going to take us back to the March and May lows. There was about a 10-point difference between these two lows. And so that's been identified as that next possible area of downside support should we close the day below this first area of support. Now, of course, on that positive side, should all of this trade war Tomorrow, there is due to be a meeting on Tuesday between China and the U.S. Certainly not expecting any miracles, but let's take a look at what we would be on the prowl for to know that this rather chaotic period potentially has ended and that the markets are in an uptrend. And I'm going to take us back to this June recovery period coming out of this May correction. And the first key component is going to be the broader market indices breaking back above that 50-day simple moving average. You also want to combine that with an RSI and stochastics that are heading upward and above neutral into positive territory. Let's take a look at the RSI currently. It is below that net neutral 50, trending downward. Stochastics just today dipping below that neutral 50 into negative. I apologize, this was done as of the close on Friday. At that point in time, it was positive. And today's action, even though the markets are up, certainly the S&P is up about 0.8%. The stochastics are still slipping below. This is all about momentum. It's not going to feed directly off of price information. So now we do have most of these indicators are now currently negative. So that's the broader market. Let's go ahead and drill down, take a look at some of the underlying components, ETFs, and other broader market indices. I've gone here to Candle Glance View, provides 12 thumbnail views of various, again, indices, sectors. And from there, I've gone ahead and added an indicator, an RSI, relative strength indicator, descending order, so we can quite quickly assess strength relative to weakness. Take a look at gold stocks. They really had quite the bounce on Friday. Of course, last week, Friday's sharp deterioration in the broader markets brought a flight to safety, and we saw gold stocks, many of these sub-gold ETFs and stocks were hitting a new high, and they are seeing a little bit more in the way of traction today. Again, today's bounce can be viewed only as anemic, not anything to be proud of, so to speak. So then from there, we can take a look at some of the subsectors, utilities, and real estate up here in the forefront. These two sectors provide yield. They also are defensive in nature and are flocked to during times of uncertainty. So we can see those are in the forefront. Consumer staples, also another defensive group that offers high yields relative to the very low treasury yields that we're seeing. And so we can see this, again, flight to defensive areas. And let's take a look at the weakest areas here. These are industrials, XLI, the industrial sector. These are stocks that are going to be really negatively impacted should we see these trade war concerns drag on, and as such, global growth deteriorates. So these multinational big industrial stocks are going to suffer. And I will tell you, there are really significant bright spots among the industrial sector. Those that subscribe to my MEM Edge report know all about it. We have stocks within there that are really outpacing the broader markets. So I urge you to go to my website and trial that newsletter. It really is quite powerful. The outperformance is significant as far as the stocks that I highlight for you to pay attention to and potentially enter. So some of the other weaker areas, financial stocks, all about the inverted yield curve, bank stocks suffering in the face of lower projected profit margins, and we can see small cap stocks suffering and so forth. But this candle glance view is very powerful. You can populate it with your list of stocks if you would like. But for our work today, we want to see where the broader markets currently are and then get a sense of those sub-industry groups among the broader markets. So that's a look there. What I do want to do is right now go ahead and share with you a scan that really was three clicks into being created. I'm going to take us over. Let me go ahead and move this so we can actually view the scan and then take a look at the results. So here we are in, again, from that initial interface page on stockcharts.com. You can get directed right into this technical scan workbench. That's the tab you're going to want to click. And it already populates that number one line. Take a look at how simple. I just added two other components. The first is a yield. I go down to ticker properties. Down here is yield. And then I want to see stocks that are yielding at least 3%. And that really is quite healthy. We talked about the treasury yields dropping. The 10-year is down in that 1.5%, possibly lower range. So 3% would be a very significant uptick from where current treasury yields are. And then from there, I want to see large cap liquid stocks. I tend to favor those, particularly in these types of rather chaotic markets. You're looking for more liquid, heavily trafficked type stocks. So this SCTR, that stands for Stock Charts Technical Rating. And the higher the number, the better. 99 is going to give you that big blast off outperformer. But really, if you ask for a 75 and higher, I'm asking for it to be greater than 75, that will provide you with a very nice selection. And in order to get that Stock Charts Technical Rating, go ahead over to this area on this scan, go down. I asked for Scooter Large. I'm looking for those large cap stocks, and I want the to be greater than 75. So quite simply from here, you can run the scan. I've already done that for us. And take a look. Here we are. These are the 16 stocks that resulted from that screen. Very clean, very simple. From here, what you can quite easily do is go ahead and sort this list by that Stock Charts Technical Rating, and it will provide you. Now, for this particular screen, I did not specify industry. I'm not going to be industry specific. I do want it to be spanning all various industries, because in essence, there you may not have captured Qualcomm. Let's take a quick look at that. Qualcomm is in that telecom equipment. A lot of people quite naturally and rightfully do put this in with tech. Sector. But let's take a look at this actual chart here, and we can see that the stock was on its way, forming the right side of a base, poised to break out. But one thing I will naturally point out to you is it really is a tech stock, because take a look at this action on Friday. It dropped in line with the markets. And then today we are seeing continued deterioration, although some areas of tech did have a nice pickup. So realistically, Qualcomm is not going to be that defensive pure play that you may be looking for. So let's go ahead and drill into some of these other stocks that are presenting to us here as being up in the forefront for their yield as well as their technical rating. So this is PSA, Public Storage. What I'm going to do from here is show you how you can check this box down below next to the volume button, ask for that full quote, and go ahead and update the chart. What this will do for you is go ahead and very clearly show you you're looking at a 3.1% yield for this particular stock. This is in the REIT space. And REIT stocks were very early movers here when the markets started to turn rather volatile. And again, this is something that was pointed out in the MEM Edge report from MEM Investment Research. But let's take a look at where we are currently with PSA. We can see that this particular stock, we're looking at a daily price chart. It broke out of this one-month base in mid-August. Let's take a look at the volume components. That's telling us that more potential demand may very well be behind it. And sure enough, the stock has continued to advance. The RSI is positive. Your MACD had that nice black line up through the red, positive signal crossover. And then we can see the stock is finding support at this upward trending 10-day simple moving average. Let's take a quick peek at what to be on the prowl for a potential pullback, because we certainly have seen a very significant advance, not only with PSA, but among REIT stocks in general. And oftentimes what you will see is an initial break below this shorter term 10-day simple moving average. And for those of you that are longer term investors, you can stay with the stock as long as it finds support above this 50-day. And then we can see a very sharp, quick recovery of this RSI. Take a look at your MACD. It never got negative. So you could very easily have stayed with it. And then for those of you looking to add to your position when that black line goes up through the red, and very similar action with this pullback end of July into the beginning of August, pulls right back to that upward trending 50-day quick dip on the RSI recovery, and then your MACD never gets below this neutral, and then this is your buy signal in. We're going to come back in about a minute. I do want to review some of those other high liquid, higher yielding stocks from our screen. So we will be right back after this.
Missed the live show? Want to rewatch a workshop? Tune into the Stock Charts TV YouTube channel to catch up on the latest programming and content. All of our live shows, workshops, special guests, and more can be found there. Each category has its own playlist, so it's easy to locate. We even have Chart School and creative strategy videos to help you become a better technical trader. Leave comments for our commentators, like your favorite videos, and don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel.
Welcome back. Here we are looking again at those scan results. Up here, we do have the criteria. We want that stock to have a 3% or greater yield. We want that stock charts technical rating to be greater than 75. And we're looking at primarily large cap stocks. You can certainly scale down into mid caps and add that to the screen. For today's purposes, I did want to keep it rather tight and refined as far as the selection list that you can then choose from. So a couple of these names are on the MEM Edge report. We can take a look at one that has been on there for quite some time. This is Entergy, ETR. Let's go ahead and take a look at that chart. And again, I am going to ask for that full quote so that I can see precisely what yield I am getting with this particular stock. So let's take a look. This stock has been in a very confirmed uptrend. It's been on our list for quite some time, but most notably is the fact that we're looking at Entergy. ETR is a daily price chart here. Take a look at the support that it is finding at this upward trending 10-day simple moving average RSI throughout this uptrending period that began back here. The RSI has remained in positive territory, as has your MACD going back to this beginning of May. So this has been a lengthy outperformer. A lot of times people think they may have missed the move, but those stocks, most of my work centers around uncovering these outperformers. They will outperform for a long period of time, primarily because there are oftentimes is a very sound reason why this particular stock. It could be because they cater to a regional area that is seeing growth. They may have different avenues or areas of energy that are attracting investors. So this particular stock, we can see it's providing a 3.3 yield and remains in, again, a very confirmed uptrend with both of your outlying indicators up there in positive territory. So let's go ahead and move on. You can certainly utilize and take a look at this scan at your own leisure as far as the results. What I did want to do is go ahead and move on. Today, I did want to share with you some really cool insights as far as consumer staple stocks. What I first wanted you to take a look at is this group graph. Take a look at this. Really, it looks as if it fell off a cliff, but this is in line with the August action. And in particular, this is XLY, the Consumer Discretionary Select Spider Fund. Let's take a look at XRT. And this is going to be Select Retail, the S&P Retail ETF. Now, this is a group that really fell out of bed. This is that May 10% correction. Did not recover for the most part. It was in the throes of potentially reversing this downtrend before the trade war effects really took hold. And this is because the September, the tariffs that are coming up very soon here are targeting, among other areas, a number of these retailers will be hit. I know Trump did lift some of them in an effort to have a promising holiday retail season, but still a lot of these names are in the bullseye. But what I did want to point out to you is, despite the deterioration within the broader group, there are definite bright spots. So let's begin by taking a look at some of the stocks that reported their earnings last week that are in the consumer discretionary retail space. This first stock is Lowe's, L-O-W. Take a look. This is a gap up of 13% on big volume subsequent to the release of their earnings. And we can see the stock did more than try. It did reverse this near term from that May correction. Lowe's was one of those retailers that was we able to be further along in that downtrend reversal. But it did get hit, of course, with the tariff fears. When we see stocks that exhibit strength going into a correction, are able to outperform and reverse the downtrend more than the group, these are your potential leadership names. You do want to pay attention. So the stock certainly got sold off, perhaps more than warranted. So hence this big 13% price gap. It would certainly have been a different story had the stock been up in this level when it reported. So the stock's lower valuation at this point in time did favor this big gap up subsequent to the company report releasing earnings that were ahead of estimates. Let's take a look at another big retailer, another home improvement one. This is Home Depot. And this particular stock, we can see it really recovered beautifully. Of the two, between Home Depot and Lowe's, Home Depot was clearly the winner, the stronger name. We can see it actually hit a new high going into this August period of uncertainty with these retailers. This stock also gapped up not quite as much. I will tell you, both companies reported 4% year-over-year earnings growth. Take a look at Home Depot. It gapped up really only 7%, but I'll take that in a negative market because since then it did go up even further. And the stock is really marking time after breaking out of this base. So of these two, Home Depot is clearly the stronger. But what I wanted to point out to you was that significant rally on Lowe's, primarily because of its lower valuation. So with that in mind, we are going to go ahead from here into a number of retailers that are due to report earnings this week. And this is with an eye toward focusing or potentially uncovering these lower value stock. One last name we're going to look at here, actually, because this is a stock target that I highlighted last Monday before they came out with their earnings. And here is the gap up. This particular stock was up 23% on these strong earnings. The reason I had pointed this stock out last Monday down in here was twofold. One, the stock had a very positive surprise back in this May period during that correction, had a significant gap up there. Taking a look at this lower valuation, because the stock did sell off on the tariff news, made the stock attractive. So twofold, it has gapped up on positive earnings surprise in the past. It has a history and also the lower valuations. So let's move into some of the names that are due to report this week. First one is Dollar Tree, DLTR. Now, this stock was a big winner going into this summer months period. However, they did report earnings and they guided lower. And so this particular stock did fall out of bed prior to this August period. I would argue it is looking relatively cheap. And I say relatively because I'm going back historically. It is not a favorite of mine because the company did guide lower, but it could very well be setting up to potentially come out ahead of numbers and potentially see a nice uptick here. I'm not a fan of trading into earnings, by the way, either, but it's something to take note of. These guys report on Thursday. Let's take a look at another stock that was a big winner earlier in the year, also fell out of bed because of lower guidance. This is Ollie, O-L-L-I. Both of these stocks are discount retailers. We're looking at daily price charts. We can see this nice significant uptrend, but this downtrend is everything to do with numbers and the company guiding lower. But I will again argue that the stock is at a very low valuation going into their release on Wednesday. The other good news is analysts are revising earnings estimates higher going into the report. That said, trading into earnings can be a bit tricky. So let's take a look. There is something else I wanted to point out to you because there are other periods when consumer discretionary stocks did fall out of favor. But there were groups among there that outperformed the broader market. So we're looking again at XLY, that group graph. I'm going to take us to a weekly price chart because what I did want to point out to you is this period going back to 2018. And I may have to do a monthly, but I did want to share this with you. Because while the broader markets and the group overall, this is not very telling. This is that correction that we experienced in the beginning of 2018. Take a look at this XLY. I might be better served to show with you the group. And you'll see that the broader markets were struggling during that beginning period of 2018. And again, we can take a quick look here. But what I did want to point out to you were stocks within. So this is a bit of a better picture of that 2018 period when the broader markets were suffering. But during that period, there were underlying consumer stocks that were really outperforming. This is Restoration Hardware. This is that same period, the beginning of 2018. The reason I'm pointing this out to you is because I'm going to take us to a group within retail that is really bucking that downtrend. This is that 2018 period. Take a look at this. This is Goose, Canada Goose. The other stock that we just looked at was Restoration Hardware. I should have shared that with you. But these are two of many, several examples. Etsy was another one going back to that period that were quite clearly outperforming while the broader markets and that group were suffering. So with that in mind, let's take a look at a couple of restaurant stocks. And I'm going to take us now to a daily chart, something a bit more current. So you can see that there are pockets of strength within consumer discretionary among retailers, despite the ugliness, certainly of that retail graph and chart. So what we can see is McDonald's, MCD, really in a very significant, nice uptrend, finding support at these shorter-term simple moving average. The stock does offer a 2.2% yield, and the company is renowned for certainly their innovation as it relates to technology delivery. They currently have a new model in place in Europe where there's no cashier, no dining room. You place your order and it is delivered. So they are upselling through technology as well. Let's take a look at Starbucks, another innovator. This stock really has outperformed, but take a look how it's just hugging this up, this well now flat 10-day simple moving average. But your RSI and your MACD are up here in positive territory. We are looking at a daily price chart. This is another innovative new products, new ways of delivery. CMG is another name that is Chipotle in that restaurant space. Take a look at how it is finding support at this upward trending 10-day. You really would not know what's going on as far as the chaos in the broader markets. The RSI is positive and this MACD. These are the type of outperformers that I'm always on the prowl for, that I share with those subscribers to the MEM Edge report, because it's not just earnings. CMG, Chipotle, does have huge growth prospects, 51% earnings this year, 30% next year. They also are renowned for their innovation, as again, it's going to be digital sales. They actually grew digital sales 99% year over year in the most recently reported earnings. So that is a concept that I did want to certainly share with you, that even though you will see areas of the market that potentially do not look healthy, oftentimes you can uncover, push your shirt sleeves up and you'll see these outperformers. One last name in the food industry, because wholesale food is an area that is really, again, withstanding this current chaos and volatility. This is US Foods Corp. This gap up is all about the earnings. And this particular company broke out of this multi-month base on huge volume, and it's continuing in this very, very nice uptrend. And this particular company actually supplies food to the restaurant space. So it's a way to play that strength in some of these retail restaurant names. And another item about this stock, they are very big with digital sales as well. They just introduced another new platform. And we can see the stock is finding support at this upward trending 10-day simple moving average. Your RSI and your MACD are very much in confirmed uptrends, very strong stock. And then one last name, I won't have time to share much information about it, but SYY, also in that wholesale food space. And not thinking I'm going to get to it, but Give it one last college try here, and you'll be able to see another chart poised to break out, holding in remarkably well. That's it for this week. For those of you trading these volatile markets, happy trading.